Hello, I'm Alex with Splunk Education. In this video, I'll show you how to set up a trial of Splunk Cloud and get data into it using a universal forwarder. From the splunk.com homepage, we click the Free Splunk button. We are asked to log in or create a Splunk account. Clicking Start Trial displays a confirmation message that you have registered for a free trial and that you will receive a confirmation email within 10 minutes. You will receive an email with a link to your login information for your Splunk Cloud trial, which contains a URL, username, and temporary password. On your first login, you will be prompted to change your password. We update our password and click Save Password. This brings us to the Splunk Cloud Terms of Service. We can review these terms, click to accept them, and click OK to complete the login process. This takes you to your Splunk Cloud homepage. On your first login, you'll see a pop-up message letting you know what's new in this release. Depending on the newest features of Splunk Cloud, you may see multiple messages. Pre-installed applications are on the left-hand side of the interface. The Search and Reporting app allows us to search, monitor, analyze, and visualize our machine data. The Universal Forwarder allows us to send machine data from external servers into our Splunk Cloud instance for indexing. In most production environments, Universal Forwarders are used as the primary source of data input. We feel to fully understand the power of Splunk, you should test with some real-world data. So for this demo, we will use a universal forwarder to send data to Splunk Cloud for indexing. Forwarders are Splunk instances that consume data and forward it to Splunk Cloud for indexing. They require few resources and have minimal impact on performance, allowing them to be installed on the machine where the data originates. In this example, we have an Apache web server we would like to monitor. We will install a universal forwarder on the server and have it send Apache data to Splunk Cloud. We select the Universal Forwarder app. There is a link to download the universal forwarder from the Splunk Downloads page, and a button to download the universal forwarder credentials to our local machine. These credentials enable the forwarder to send data to the Splunk Cloud service. We click the Splunk Downloads link and are taken to a download page. We select the OS and version of our web server. Accept the general terms of agreement and select Access Program to begin our download. Splunk also provides an option to use wget if you choose. Returning to our Splunk Cloud instance, we download the Universal Forwarder credentials. The Universal Forwarder package and credentials need to be moved to the web server. For this demo, we've already logged in and uploaded the files to our web server. Splunk can live in any accessible directory. In this demo, we'll install in the opt directory. So let's untar the archive there. We then navigate to the bin directory inside the Splunk Forwarder folder. The bin directory is where we can run the executable command Splunk. The Splunk commands you'll use most are start, stop, and restart. But a full list can be seen using the help command. We start the forwarder for the first time using the Splunk start command. We want to automatically accept the license, so we add the optional Accept License argument. We're prompted to set up an admin account with a password and confirm it. To keep data from being lost, a universal forwarder should start whenever the server reboots. So we use the Enable Boot Start command next. Now that we have the universal forwarder set up, we install our credentials. The installation is authorized with the admin account we created for the universal forwarder. To complete our app installation, we restart the forwarder with the restart command. Now to get data forwarding to our Splunk Cloud instance. The add monitor command is used to tell the universal forwarder what machine data to send to Splunk Cloud. Here, we are telling the forwarder to send all logs located in the www2 folder to Splunk Cloud for indexing. Returning to the Splunk Cloud interface, we run a search to verify the data is being indexed on our Splunk Cloud instance. Now that we have the data indexed, we can start building reports and visualizing our data. For more information on using Splunk Cloud, we recommend you check out the documentation, watch additional videos on our Splunk How-To channel, and register for courses from Splunk Education. Thanks for watching.